And welcome to the next training, Google Analytics. So this is really an important piece because this is what is gonna show us which of the content is actually profitable, what to scale, what to stop, which campaigns to stop. So everything has to be tracked. So the more important aspect in this business is about tracking. So what I will do is how we are gonna track and what is the requirement to track and what are elements in the tracking that we are gonna look at, right? So I have created a checklist and so just follow this. So very first thing, let's assume that you have a blog with already 30 content and approved by Google AdSense and other networks. So next thing is, I mean, obviously we will have to bring in traffic to the blog so that you will start seeing some earning, and also like we should understand which of the content is really working and how it is performing, right? So the first thing is applying for Google Analytics, right? So I have given an URL here, marketingplatform.google.com. So this is the URL. So if you know, I mean, earlier it was google.com/analytics, and now obviously Google simplified everything into a single dashboard, which is called Marketing Platform. So just click on sign into analytics, right? Now, once you sign in, obviously you may not have an analytics that is linked, right? So all you need to do is, I mean, once you log in, so Google will take you to a page where you just it will say that you will have to create an a code for a website to track. So this is the first page. I mean, so I'll just give an example. Okay, and I say next. Okay, so now obviously I want to measure web, right? So I'm not doing anything on app or apps and web, only web I'm gonna track. Right. So the next thing is, obviously we'll give a name. Right. So you said the industry and you also said the reporting time zone. Right. So health is one category which we talked about the last video as an example. Now, obviously, based on your time zone, I mean, reporting time zone, you can choose that. All you need to do is just create. So then Google is going to ask, agree to the terms and condition, right? I'm sorry. So basically this, I've just used a test.com. So it's saying permission denied, right? So what I will do is, so, so once you give on yes to all, you agree the terms and condition of Google, right? So you will be given a tracking ID and a tracking code widget, right? Which you will have to place it in your site to start tracking. So for that reason, I mean, how are you gonna link your GA with your website? So I know that if, let's say, assume that you are technically strong enough, so you can take the code and put it in header section of your site. Now, let's say that you don't have that or you're unaware of such thing. So I have given an option where there is a WordPress plugin called Google Analytics Dashboard for VP. So GAADWP, right? So once you install this plugin, okay, and then it'll ask for an authorization, which is very similar to like how you are signing into Google Analytics, right? So you sign in and then you authorize it. So you are done. I mean, so which means that like very, it's as simple as that. You just get the GA code, apply and get the GA code. And the second thing is, you are gonna install a WordPress plugin in your blog, which is called GADWP, right? And then you are authorizing it and linking it. So most of the things are done here. So now the third thing is, let's say that you have completed all the process and you've also started driving a lot of traffic, right? Now, to understand which of your content is working really well, we will have to link our AdSense with GA, right? So for that reason, I mean, you have an okay. So I'm logged into my one of my websites, Google Analytics. So you see something called behavior in the left, right? And then where we have an option called publisher, right? So I have already linked my Google AdSense with Analytics, so obviously I will be shown a different page here. So if let's say you have not linked, Google will throw an option for you to link it. So basically, without any data, it cannot show you anything. So it'll say you to link it. So it's I assume that you'll be doing the same. You will create an analytics code with the same email ID as you have applied for AdSense. So the process is simple. I mean, you just link both with the option that is being shown, right? So after you link it, Google will take a day to understand. I mean, to start getting in data. Now I have linked, so that is why you are able to see a lot of informations here. So here, what we need to track is. So let's say I go to publisher pages. So now what happens is each of my URL here, it's actually showing me different data. So the impression, the coverage, the CTR, the revenue. Publisher revenue per every 100 sessions, publishers eCPM. So CPM is cost per mil. So the concept is simple. As long as the eCPM is more than 50 cents, right? So which means the content is already profitable. So I look at making it better. So obviously, if you see certain contents like this one, it's having an eCPM of 17 cents, right? So you can actually create a custom URL in Google AdSense itself and track, but that is restricted with only with 100 of your URL to track, right? Now here there is no restriction, so what I do is I simply link my GA with my AdSense, and then I start looking at the data, and I see which one is performing, which one is not performing. So the advantage is, I mean, same like we give an UTM parameter, right? So we can also give certain tags. So so for each of my campaign that I run in different networks, I say which country and what was the CPC cost. So different things. So from each, so why I do this is to understand whether which of the country is actually working for me, and what is the eCPM, and how was the revenue performed. Right, so it's and in fact, I also use different banners to drive traffic. Right, I also understand which of my banner is giving me better eCPM, etc. So the thing is, it's very simple. I mean, as long as we can understand the data and work towards understanding the best performing content, obviously we'll be more profitable. So let's say now if I if I filter based on ECP. So you see the effective cost per million. I mean, so which means I understand with this how it is performing and how different country has performed, right? So now to add additional tag of country, cost, and banners, we will talk in a different video when we are actually creating an ad to drive traffic, right? So so this is all it is in Google Analytics. So here it's not an e-commerce store, or it's not an services that you offer. It's more into content. As long as the content is better and it is more profitable, you make more revenue and more money. Is as simple as that. Now that is why in terms of choosing which content to go about what to write, so I typically choose the content which is having high CPC, which means advertisers are able to throw up ads on my site, right? I mean, through Google. So it will show a related ad very specific to the content. So the CPC is ideally higher for me. So yeah, to sum up, I'll go through again. We need to apply Google Analytics. The link is given. Then we'll have to install an WordPress plugin. Again, GADWP is the plugin. And then we link the Google Analytics with the AdSense. And we start tracking. And we start tracking scientifically how which of the content is performing, which country is performing, which banner is performing, effectively, which gives a better eCPM of more than 50 cents. And that we scale it up. Okay, cool. See you then in next video. Thank you.